that's new.
Yes. Well, I'm going to spin this one off. What do you know? But I don't know anything about this yet. Then we got one more thing we're going to get to, the Sooner Politics thing. We're going to get to this David Harden, the Harden Manifesto, you call it.
Yes, yes.
That's pretty heavy.
Yeah.
Well, that kind of segued in.
Well, I'm going to get there, but no, I want to know about, did you hear about Lincoln? Who knows about Lincoln Chafee? Do you know anything about Lincoln Chafee?
Yes, but
he switched over to being libertarian.
Okay.
Oh, I had not heard that.
This is just brand new news.
Oh, did not hear that.
He was a senator from which state? I'm trying to remember.
Oh,
but anyway.
He was on the,
he was Republican.
Republican, and he went libertarian.
Connecticut? I don't know. This is your story, aren't you?
Again, I'm just moving through these things to see if you guys know. I'm pressing you. I'm not the expert here. I'm just the host.
That's true.
On the one hand, that is encouraging. On the other, it's sad that he went libertarian. Just because I would rather him have gone Constitutional Party or something like that. It's, you know, a little more legit constitutionally. But it's good because although he will generally vote with the Republicans and keep things, it's going more to liberty. We've said it a couple times tonight already. They've overplayed their hand, and we're seeing it time and time and time again. And people are rising up across the country on issue after issue after issue because they're overplaying their hand, and both sides. In many cases are overplaying their hand to the point that people are now fed up with it, and people in government are even fed up with it.
Well, I tell a lot of libertarians that are serious about getting something done to influence the Republican Party because it has the mechanisms to get things done.
Right.
Whereas the Libertarian Party in the state of Oklahoma and elsewhere is fairly pathetic.
Just almost anybody joining the Libertarian Party to me looks like a splintering of the Libertarian Party.
Let me respond to this because the Constitution Party. I found out over the winter break, especially with our House Democrats in Congress, everybody's a constitutionalist. I just can't figure out which constitution they're referring to. And I'm going to apply this even to the Constitution Party.
Right.
Because I know several of the people who've been part of that, and they all have a different view of what our society is supposed to look like if we were being constitutional. Because what it comes down to, and I'll say this about my libertarian friends, big L libertarians, is that, look, everybody's selfish in different ways. And that's the problem we got to get over is our selfishness, because we all want liberty for me. But we're not so we're really troubled by your liberties, and you're going to be a threat to me. So I want to hamper your liberties, but I want to expand mine.
As an overreaching generalization,
exactly.
Which is the crux of the problem.
Sure,
and they don't even realize that they're shooting themselves in the foot because it's like a friend of mine from Oregon. She voted against medical marijuana when she had the chance to vote for it, and then her granddaughter was vaccine injured and needed CBD to get over the seizures and so forth from the neurological damage, and she says, I need that marijuana now, I need those ingredients, and I can't get them, and I voted against it. She realized she had shot herself in the foot.
Right.
The thing is that the pain delay is so great that, and often people just never practice those actions that they need those rights for, so they just don't even recognize that they're gone. I mean, if you're not a drinker, what do you care that drink?
You're watching 3D Politics at Tom E. McKay on Twitter, and I got David Oldham and David D'Ambroso right here on 3D Politics.